السلام علیکم ورحمۃ اللہ وبرکاتہ فرینڈز، ویلکم بیک ٹو مائی چینل۔ ان ویڈیو نمبر 1073 آئی ریپیئر دس ڈیلٹا پاور سپلائی اینڈ آئی فاؤنڈ دس ایم او وی ورسٹر شارٹ سرکٹڈ اینڈ آئی ریسیوڈ کامنٹ فرام مائی ویور، کین یو ایکسپلین ہاؤ ٹو سلیکٹ کریکٹ ایم او وی فار پروٹیکٹنگ سرکٹ رننگ آن 230 وولٹ؟ ڈو یو آلسو ہیو ٹو take the current of the circuit into account؟ We will make this video in two portions. In first portion, we will study what is surge protection, what are the basics of surge protection, why we need surge protection. We will check data sheet and I will explain what are the basic parameters that are involved in selection of this MOV, resistor, VDR, voltage dependent resistor. This is a power supply. If you connect line and neutral, it will reach to EMI protection circuit, first stage, second stage. It is a barrier. It protects the next circuit to enter any high frequency noises into this power supply, and it will block all the noises, switching noises within this power supply to the outside circuit. So it will make a barrier here. It will block the noises, differential mode and common mode noises. Class Y capacitors, class X capacitors, these will protect this power supply. That are high frequency noises. That is EMI, electromagnetic interference or radio frequency interference. In the first step, we will see what is surge. Line voltage, either it is 110 volt, 115, 120, 220, 240, 230, it is pure sine wave. Either it is coming from any inverter, generator, any source. Normally, there is no need to use any type of protection here. But in real life, there are different type of noises which enter in this signal. If you turn on mobile phone near this line, that frequency will also enter in this signal. That is called EMI. There is communication tower, radios, all type of electromagnetic pulses will interfere this sine wave, and that will disturb in high side, low side. This will clean that noises. If there is some lightning strike at that time in this 230 volt, a pulse will arrive here that is around 25,000 volts approximately, like this. Switching on any device, for example refrigerator is turning on, power motor that is turning on, that will also disturb this line voltage. That time the voltage will reach around 600 volts, 700 volts. If there is any electromagnetic pulse, there is some type of explosion. So line voltage will disturb. If there is electrostatic discharge, that can reach up to 15 kilovolts. From lightning strike, the current will approximately 20,000 amperes. For switching, that pulse can produce 500 ampere current in just 50 microseconds. This is surge. That is sudden rise in the amplitude. It is in microseconds. Lightning strike, that pulse might be just only 1 millisecond. Switching noise might be 500 milliseconds. Any explosion, just only 1 millisecond. ESD, electrostatic discharge, might be it is 100 nanoseconds. But that pulse can damage our first semiconductor component, that is diode. In this condition, if you don't have any protection device, line neutral will reach to these passive components, then these passive components, then we have this semiconductor component. If you have 10 microsecond pulse, 1 millisecond pulse. That pulse will cause to make a short link in the capacitor. Why? Because its XC will decrease. This inductor will produce inductive reactance. Its inductive reactance will increase depending on the frequency, pulse type. But when we see data sheet of this diode, if you check data sheet for this first exposed semiconductor to the line voltage, it is 600 volts normal DC voltage, that are blocking voltage, peak voltage, and RMS voltage 420 volts. At that time, it will produce 15 ampere current, that is average forward rectified output current. But in case the voltage will increase, at that time that will cause to flow more and more current. And this bridge rectifier, D15XB60, normal current 15 ampere, that is continuous current. But 240 ampere current for 8.3 millisecond, just only in one peak, a very short duration pulse. After that, it will break down. It will damage non-repetitive peak forward surge current. Single half sine wave superimposed on rated load. After 8.3 milliseconds, this will damage. To protect this bridge rectifier, this diode, we need surge suppressor, surge protector, surge arrestor, MOV, VDR, voltage dependent resistor, or anything which can clip off these voltage. Different type of pulses can arrive on this line to clip off this pulse, because it is very short duration pulse. We need MOV, metal oxide varistor, VDR, voltage dependent resistor, that is this component. Its symbol is, it is nonpolar. It is made by oxides, different type of oxides. It is non-ohmic. It works in different regions because it is connected in parallel line immediately after the fuse line and neutral. When the voltage are within safe limit, its internal resistance is infinity, or we can say from 100 mega ohm to thousands mega ohm. It works as an open circuit, that is non-conductive state. It is current voltage. When the voltage are increasing, this MOV, when it is connected to voltage 280 volt, for example, until 280 volt, it will remain silent. It will work in open circuit range, high resistance range. When the voltage will exceed from this level, that are V nominal, that time it will start to transfer in conduction range, that is called V1 milliampere range. This time approximately 1 milliampere, 0.001, this current will flow at this range. These are nominal voltage. Working voltage 230 volt, nominal voltage this one. These voltage are also named as V1MA. Let's see data sheet. Here are part numbers and branding First, RMS voltage, 130 volt, 140, 230 volt. We can say, we will see this one. These are working voltage, 230 volt to 300 volt. Then V nominal, 324 volt. Okay, I will write 324 volt. This is condition that is called 1 milliampere DC test current. At that time, this MOV will reach in protection mode. It will become active because these MOVs are metal oxides, so its grains are activated now. V nominal minimum to maximum. This MOV will start working between this voltage range, minimum to maximum. It may start at 324 volt or up to 396 volt. When the voltage are increasing now, it will start conduction. Now voltage are increasing, but it will clamp the voltage at this level. That are 595 volt. And this time, peak current will 10 ampere. Here is now transient condition. If any transient, any pulse will arrive 8 by 20 microsecond. That means if any pulse that will start from T0 and it will reach up to 90% of its peak from T0, from zero line to 90% of the peak, it is called T1. If any pulse will reach at 90% in 8 microseconds, so this is first time. After 8 microseconds, if the pulse remains high up to 50% of its peak, this time will cover from T0 to 50%, that is 20 microseconds. 8 microseconds for rising, 12 microseconds for falling. It is called 8 by 20 or 8 over 20. If one pulse with this time duration, 8 microseconds for rising up to 90%, next 12 microseconds for falling from 90% to 50% in the decay, at that time it will allow current 1750 amperes. This one. And if we are discussing this one, it will allow 3500 ampere current. If two pulses, that is 2500. Most of the time it is calculated by multiple pulses. So circuit will be protected up to 40 pulses. And how much energy it will use in 2 milliseconds, that is 42 joules. In this region it was working at high resistance mode. Here approximately 3000 ohms. So it will cause to flow 1 milliampere current here. Before this open circuit, now 1 milliampere. When the voltage will increase, so it will allow that current, that is 3500 amperes, which we are discussing here for one pulse. And it will dissipate power. If the pulses are, such pulses are striking again and again, that will cause to increase its substrate temperature. It will melt. When it will melt, it will make short circuit between these two terminals, this one and this one. That is catastrophic failure. It will damage. In the meantime, the fuse will open. When fuse will open, the next circuit will be protected. So this response in both directions. Now if we are selecting any MOV, any resistor, if we need more current, this MOV comes in disk size. That is this disk size. It is in millimeter, 3 mm, 5 mm, 7 mm, 10 mm, 14, 20. Each disk size has its own current level. Then if we need far more voltage, that time its thickness will increase. More thick, more voltage. Larger disk size will handle larger strike. Then maximum clamping voltage, that is also 8 by 20 microsecond pulses, when the voltage will increase. If we see this disk size, 7V07E230P, it will clamp voltage at 595 with 10 ampere current. 10 ampere current in this path. And if we select chip size, disk size number 10, V10, 10 millimeter, it will allow 25 ampere current. If we select disk size 14 millimeter, it will allow 50 ampere current. And if we select 20 mm disk size, it will handle 100 ampere. Then the last, that is capacitance. When this MOV is working in continuous working voltage mode, below 1 milliampere, that is leakage current mode, that is high impedance mode, at that time it provides capacitance. Chip size 7, 100 picofarad, chip size 10, 250, 14, 550, 20, 1100 picofarad. This is the capacitance. When it is working in normal mode, it will allow leakage current that is negligible, and its capacitance will remain approximately same at different voltage level. When it will jump in nominal voltage range, that is V1 milliampere, at that time its capacitance will decrease, because at that time it will work in resistive mode. It will work in conduction mode. And when it will work in clamping mode, at that time it will handle as a short circuit. So in upcoming session we will calculate all necessary parameters to select the correct MOV for the protection. I hope this video is informative for you. If it is good, hit the like button. If you have any question, please write in the comments. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.